Hi, my name is Ron Lehman. I am from the Faux School, and today I'm going to show you a finish that we simply call crushed leather. Now, I made another video called crushed leather, and the problem is they both look like crushed leather. One has a texture, one doesn't. A lady named Susan sent me a note saying, could I use the crushed leather faux technique with the texture on a countertop? And I don't think it's a good idea to use that on a countertop because it has a texture to it, a relief. And even with enough coats of you're going to use a lot of polyurethane to bury that texture so it's smooth, and that way when you put something on the countertop it doesn't catch the texture. So this finish is a great alternative because it's smooth, no texture, only needs about 5 coats of polyurethane to make it smooth and protect it, or smoother and protect it, and you can use it on your countertops, floors. I do a lot of it on walls, ceilings. It gives it a very nice rustic look. You could do any color combination possible. This is just very, very popular. I've even used this on columns for a real kind of quick and simple marbly effect. And there you go. So let's get our tools, let's get our materials, and let's show you how to do this fun little finish. See you in just a little bit. Okay, so the first thing we've done to get ready is I have base coated my surface using an acrylic eggshell enamel paint. Acrylic, made with acrylic resin, cleans up with soap and water. Acrylic resin paint is a much harder, durable finish versus latex, which is still a water-based or cleans up with soap and water, but acrylic is better. In this case, Sherwin-Williams Duration, eggshell. Eggshell is the sheen level, flat, satin, semi-gloss, gloss, high gloss. Rolled it using a 3/8 inch nap roller. And I do that small nap roller because I don't want any roller texture. I want it smooth. That way a heavier nap texture or a heavier nap roller is going to leave a heavier texture, and it's going to affect my overall finish. The glaze I'm going to use is my classic wall glaze. Classic wall glaze is an interior-exterior paint glaze that tints with acrylic or latex paint, never pigment. The reason you cannot use pigment in classic wall glaze is because it does not have dryers in it. If you put pigment in it and put it to the wall, it's never going to dry. It really is never going to dry. So we just add in 1 quart of paint to 1 gallon of glaze. Boom, there we go. Base coat in this case is called Toasty, again from Sherwin-Williams. And the top coat is called Saddle Up. Now, our tools, very simple tools. First we need some clean, soft rags. Second thing we're going to need is fine 3/8 inch nap roller. For this case, I'm going to use a 4 inch. If I was doing a big wall, I'd use a 7 inch, not a 9 inch. And the reason why is even though these walls look smooth in these brand new houses, they're not. They're far from it. Sorry, it's true. And when you get in there with a 9 inch roller and all of a sudden you find that somebody sanded a spot too hard or built up a seam too high and you get a little depression, you get thicker portions of glaze in that area. We don't want that. It's unfortunate, but it's a fact. Just use a 7-inch roller. Now, the most important tool for today is going to be our plastic. This is a roll from the paint store, home improvement store, doesn't matter, but it's real thin. And I get big rolls because I want big sheets because I'm doing the whole wall, and I usually have a helper doing big walls. So this is 0.7 millimeters thick. It's very, very thin. And that's what we want. Too thick and it's not going to look right. It's actually going to look really horrid because we get these real heavy, heavy, hard patterns. We don't want that. Now, this is probably about 12 feet wide, so be careful when you're doing this. I'm going to cut a small piece. Set the rest on the side away. Put down those scissors. I'm going to open it up as far as I can. There it is. Big piece. Let's split this in half. Now I'm going to take it and crinkle it up. This does two things. Gets rid of the factory creases and the folds, and creates brand new creases and folds in very organic patterns. Now I'm just going to stretch it out. See, stretching it out still doesn't make it smooth. That's what we want. Let's set it to the side. Do the same thing with another piece, because I know what somebody's thinking. A He's got a small board. He's going to do one piece. How am I going to see a seam? Because of my big walls, I'm going to have seams. I'm going to show you. I'm going to do two pieces. Okay, taking my roller. Let's roll this out. Take your time. You don't want to pile it on like a pile, like you're painting a wall. It's okay if some of the base color pokes through its glaze. It's not supposed to be thick and heavy like a paint. What you don't want to make, don't want, and make sure that you don't get are roller marks. They can come through if you're not careful. Okay, there we go. Step one, done, out of the way. Set this off to the side so it doesn't bump my hands. All right, let's get this going. I'm gonna take my plastic. There you go. Notice I didn't push this piece in. That's my seam. If I push that in, I'm going to see that line. I don't want to see that line. All right. And I just blow with my breath because it's just easier to get it on the surface. Okay. Now I'm going to take my soft rag. And in circular patterns, make sure I press this plastic into that glaze. Because I want to make sure I have 100% contact between the plastic and the glaze. If I don't, you're going to see dark spots and variations. See what happens. Oh, look at that. See where I missed it? Right there, dead center. No big deal. If it happens, you just take your plastic and a nice, controllable, manageable size piece. And I'm just going to simply press in and get rid of it. That's it. I'll let it dry, and there's nothing else I need to do. So there you have a real simple, texture-free, crushed leather faux finish that you can use on walls, ceilings, countertops like Susan asked about, and pretty much anything else. You can even do it on floors. If you're going to do a countertop or a floor, I would put at least 5 coats of a good quality polyurethane on a countertop. And then I'd probably finish it with a wax layer to protect it. Same thing with the floor. That's all there is to it. I would pull the tape off at this point, and that's it. We're done. So, there you go. Thanks for watching. My name is Ron Lehman. I'm from the Faux School. See you soon.